Hello, beloved. It's Tony. I had sort of a negative comment today, and so I'm just going to start this one off with, this is my perception. This is how I perceive things. Okay, and what I wanted to show the other day, I was told to sign here. And I don't know, and I mean, just some of the studies and the things I've been looking at and such as that, I just did this. And the young girl looked at it and she's like, wow, that's an interesting signature. And I told her, I said, yeah, it's unpronounceable and it is undefinable. D-F-I-N-A. Okay. Unpronounceable and undefinable. And what I want to kind of show you, because see, a sign, and this is a sign, and what I'm proposing is normally I should have done a signature, all right? And a signature is a sign, okay? And a nature is like a caricature, okay? A literature, a signature, and so this is a like. Okay, a likeness. And what I'm going to propose is your signature, okay, which normally that would be my signature, all right? And so this signature is my likeness, all right? And what we're getting into is what's called the straw man, okay? And the straw man is a corporation because the likeness or the signature is in all capital letters. Okay, so that signature would be associated with a corporation that was done in all capital letters. All right, so what happens is this likeness becomes the logos, your likeness. Okay, and it is pronounceable, you see, and it is definable, okay? And what I'm going to show you is even on your Social Security card, they have the two columns, and then it's like your number, okay? And your name is in capital letters here, okay? And this is a corporation. Okay, but a corporation is a non-living entity, all right? Now here's what they do. You have, let me move up a little bit, and this is just, it's just the way I see these things, and this is corporate law here, an ID. And usually an ID will be specifications, okay? And this is sort of equal to length, width, and height for the cube, okay? Your cube here, length, width, and height, ID. So it'd be like name, date of birth, social security number, okay? It would be color of hair, color of eyes, address, okay? And like when you're agreeing to these, you're committing to the corporation because of the signature of the logos of the likeness, all right? But this, so then what they do is, it's just amazing. This is how things work. Your ID is a likeness, and on it will have usually three specifications or defining definitions. Okay, and it's almost like, you know, the weight, again, the color of hair, the color of eyes. Okay, well, weight, 165 pounds, okay, color of hair, brown, color of eyes, brown. Well, that just defined 30%, 70%, 50% of the population. Do you understand what I'm saying? Okay, and so they tried to convince you that this ID is you, and it's not you. It may be a likeness, but it is not you. You are you. this ID is not you. Secondly, they will say, the ID says, okay, no, the ID says nothing. Okay, so it's just this major trick. Because what happens is, everything that is corporate or the straw man, they own it, okay? You're not sovereign. It's an incredible thing to look at. So I'm going to stop there. But, changes the game, I think. All right, and this is just really funny. And I want to go on because this symbol is what I put there. And this is just why, because this thing has been sort of just working in my head. I'm going to put a link in here to a video, and it's about what's called N-E-Y-E-N. Nyen, okay? And it's spelled the same way this way and this way, okay? And it's about what's called the Nyen Square, all right? The Nyen Square. And the center word here is I, E-Y-E. Oh, I got to show you this because this is backwards. It's like this. N-E-Y-E. E, sorry, I did it all backwards. Yeah, and then so this one would be up, down, up. Nyen. All right, well, here's the funny thing. The word I, okay, I is in the middle, and these two N's are backwards, and I want to show you something. When I was learning to draw that symbol that I just showed you, and I'm going to put it here for you, all right, that's half of it. And it's like the N, it's a backwards N, what this is right here, a backwards N. All right, then, after it goes here, then it is a correct N, up, back, up. So the two N's together makes this symbol, okay? And the way I interpret this is I, and this is I am. All right, and what happens is, and I've shown this also, this symbol, okay, is actually, if you were, let's see if I can draw this, okay, now this thing can be hitting in the corners of the cube, this is the corners of the cube, okay, or each side of the cube, okay, if you change this thing and hit in the dead center, you get this. Okay, dead center. These are corners, and I'm just going to link in what I'm talking about here. And then when you hit this right here, you actually hit it on all six sides of the cube in the dead center. Okay, or you can go from corner to corner. And to me, I think the corner to corner is out of balance. It's out of balance. That's why this right here, the hitting in the center. But and I just wanted to kind of link this back to Nyen. But she's a brilliant woman, especially about the Nyen sequence. And a lot of the work she's done actually ties into the same symbol in Metatron's cube. And I want to show this real quick. I'm going to put this in because this is just what I keep getting. There's a video. It's called Tether, all right? And in the video, it's showing two cubes floating. Two cubes floating. And then I'm going to draw this. Okay. And this is like the Ark of the Covenant. Right, and what I'm going to say is it's two cubes. One is male, one is female. Okay, and what it is the two together, and God is in the mercy seat here. Okay, and these in the mercy seat here. Okay, and these two is pair of dice or paradise. Okay, and what is happening in this particular video, I'm going to show a clip in real quick. You're going to see the two cubes are merging together. All right, and the merging together of the two cubes is going to take you back to, let me see here, this right here. Okay, the two cubes merge together as one. And then what it is, it's sort of the perception. It's a female perception and a male perception. Okay, and it's even the idea, and I've got to just put this in here, and I don't know which one is which, because see, that's the funny thing. I don't know which one is which, and that's where it's a good thing. Okay, but one is like good, and one is like evil. Sorry, I'm doing that because Eve sinned first on the apple thing, so I'm going to list that way. Okay, but you see, and that's the thing. You've become as gods, knowing the difference. And the cube is back to the 3D world. And the 3D world is made up of sight, sound, smell, taste, touch. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, okay, so there's all five of them. So this 3D cube is made up of everything that you see, feel, hear, smell, taste, and touch. Okay, but there's actually two views to everything. Okay, and we would call that a masculine and a feminine. All right, or yin and yang, or hot and cold, or up and down, or sun and moon. All right, and I want to show this because, and I've got a photo here that I'm going to put up because it's so interesting. When I did the video about the 7 days of the week, okay, I also showed that same symbol, okay, and it's got like the sun, the moon, Saturn, I think Jupiter, Venus. I'm not sure. Come on, one more. Oh, what is the other one? I have it. Okay, voila. All right, and so even that, you see, because of those signs, and I don't know, this stuff is just amazing. Because this is tied into the cube. This is also two stars. Okay, if you take one star, and then also if you take an opposite star, turn one this way, and there is 33 degrees between them. If you rotate one, 33 degrees, all right? And if you merge them together, you get this. And it's actually sort of, I draw this line right here. Okay, you can start to see, and the other point goes from here to here. Sorry, here to here. And then this one is hidden here, here to here. But it's just incredible because, I don't know, it's the geometry of things. But I wanted to talk about the logos and the straw man this evening. Because the other evening when I was told to sign here, I did. I put a sign there. And the funny thing is your signature is like your logo. Your logo no different than Ford, no different than any of the other, you know, corporations. I had a Burger King, McDonald's, Nike, you know, all of them. It was funny, I was looking today. This is like the symbol on one of the cars. It was like a Nissan maybe, or Honda or something. And I just thought, you know, it was so funny because it's just missing the other N, the reversed N, or the correct one. Boom, boom, boom. Here. Yeah, so that would have been just to complete it. Same thing though. Two N's. I am. All right, have a good evening.